Good morning to all my dear students. Children, today we are going to start chapter number 3, A Pound of Butter. Okay? So children, this is the chapter that we will start today, A Pound of Butter. Let us see what is given in this chapter. Read about a baker who gets worried when his cakes suddenly stop turning out well. Who is a baker, children? A baker is a person who bakes cakes, pastries, cookies. Do you love eating them? Yes, I know. Little children, they love eating all these things. So why was the baker worried? Why were his cakes not turning out well? What was the matter? Let us see in the chapter. Now, Farmer Winston had a large farm near the little town of Plainsville. The people of Plainsville were dependent on Farmer Winston. Dependent for what? For milk, butter, and cheese. Even Mr. Carson, the baker. Who was Mr. Carson? He was the baker, okay, who lived in that little town. Even Mr. Carson, the baker, bought his supplies from Farmer Winston. Now, children, you all know, for baking cakes or pastries, milk is required, okay? So, the baker, Mr. Carson, he used to purchase milk, butter, and cheese from Farmer Winston. Okay, that was his usual practice. What happened next? Every morning, Farmer Winston drove up to the bakery and delivered the day's supply. So, Farmer Winston, every day, he used to supply the milk to the baker. Milk came in large metal cans. There were large round blocks of creamy cheese, and the golden yellow butter came in 1 pound packets shaped like bricks. Now, the shape were like the bricks. Okay, the butter shape were like the bricks. What is the meaning of pound, children? Now, children, you all know that when you go to the market to buy something, we either say, give us 1 kilogram of any item. So in places like Britain, America, and other countries where English is spoken, they do not use kilograms. Hai na? Kg use nahi karte, 1 kg dijiye, 1 kilogram dijiye. They use pound in that place, okay? Pound is also a unit of weight. It is used for measuring weight. Okay, how heavy an object is. So for that, they use the term pound. So, where were we? Yes, there were large round blocks of creamy cheese and the golden yellow butter came in 1 pound packets shaped like bricks. Okay, next, what is given? Mr. Carson was a good baker. His cakes were the lightest in town and his bread was delicious. Delicious means tasty. He enjoyed his work. But this morning, Mr. Carson was frowning. What is the meaning of frowning, children? Children, when people frown or when someone is frowning, they are usually worried or annoyed. They are not happy, okay? And when anyone will frown, they bring their eyebrows closer together. So one day what happened? Mr. Carson was little worried. He was frowning. For the last few days, his cakes had not turned out well as they usually did. Now you all know, children, Mr. Carson was a very good baker. But why his cakes were not turning out well? there must be something wrong. But he could not understand it. He had used the same amount of everything, butter, sugar, eggs and flour. But the cakes were not the same. So everyday baker was using the same amount of butter, sugar, eggs and flour. But why now his cakes were not turning out well? What was the problem? Mr. Carson began to get suspicious. Suspicious means when there is something wrong going on, you become suspicious. Or you can say, if you are suspicious of someone, you do not trust them. You do not trust a person when you are suspicious. So Mr. Carson, what did he think? It was the butter. He was sure of it. Now Mr. Carson was very sure that there was something wrong with the butter that he was purchasing from the farmer. He was sure that the bricks of butter that Farmer Winston delivered were not the correct weight and that they did not weigh a pound each. He decided to find out. Now what happened, children? Mr. Carson, he was very sure that the butter that he was buying from the farmer Winston were not of the correct weight and they did not weigh a pound each. For preparing the cake, he was buying how much pound of butter? 1 pound. But definitely the farmer is not selling him 1 pound. He must be playing the fool and giving him less butter. This is what he thought and he decided to find out. For several days, soon after Farmer Winston delivered the supplies, Mr. Carson weighed the butter on his scales. And just as he thought, each brick weighed less than a pound. So, each brick of butter that he was buying from the farmer, it was not of 1 pound weight. It was less than a pound. Mr. Carson was very angry. No wonder his cakes were not turning out right. So now he came to know that what was the reason his cakes were not turning out well. It was the butter, because the farmer was giving him less butter. That is why his cakes were not turning out well. So what did he do? He complained to the police and they arrested the farmer for cheating. And at the trial, what is the meaning of trial? In a trial, a person is asked questions in a court to decide whether they have done something wrong. So children, what happens when somebody has to undergo a trial? He has to answer a number of questions that a judge puts to him. Okay, children, in a trial, the person has to answer a number of questions asked by the judge. Okay, so what happened? At the trial, the judge turned to Farmer Winston and said, "The baker says that you sold him butter that was not the correct weight. Do you have weighing scales at home?" So what is the judge asking to the farmer? That when you are selling the butter, are you weighing it in a weighing machine? Kya tum uska vajan karke bechte ho? "No, your honor," replied the farmer. So what is the farmer saying? No, he is not weighing the butter. So what is the judge asking next? "Then how do you weigh the butter you sell?" So the judge is asking, "Then when you are selling something, how are you weighing it?" Farmer Winston replied. What did he say? "I use a balance, but my little son lost the weights while playing with them. So now to weigh the butter, I use 1 pound loaf of bread that I buy from Mr. Carson. So what is the farmer saying? That I was having a balance at home. Okay children, balance is something that is used to weigh something. किसी चीज का वजन नापने के लिए हम लोग balance use करते हैं. Okay? So what is the farmer saying? That I was having a balance at my home, but my little son has lost it. He was playing with it and he had lost it. He has misplaced it. So now how I am weighing the butter? How I am weighing? I am using 1 pound loaf of bread that I buy from Mr. Carson. So the farmer is using 1 loaf of bread that he purchases from Mr. Carson. Okay. The farmer also used to buy bread from Mr. Carson children. Farmer was giving butter and the baker was giving a loaf of bread to the farmer. So what was the farmer doing? He was using 1 pound loaf of bread to weigh the butter. On one side he was keeping the loaf of bread that he was buying and to the other side he was keeping the butter. But because the baker was giving him less bread, less quantity of bread, so therefore butter was also weighed according to the weight of the loaf of bread. क्योंकि बेकर उसे कम वजन का दे रहा था, right? Now actually what happened children, the farmer was selling butter to the baker, okay? And the baker was also selling his loaf of bread to the farmer. Both of them were selling things to each other. Farmer उसे बटर दे रहा था and baker was giving a loaf of bread to the farmer. But how was the farmer weighing the butter? वो कैसे वजन करता था? He was not having the balance. He had lost it. So he was using 1 pound loaf of bread that he had bought from the baker to weigh his butter. What does this show children? It shows that the baker was a dishonest man. Baker was not selling according to the right quantity. So children, this story teaches you a moral that you must learn to be honest. Who is an honest person children? A person who speaks the truth. Okay, so this story teaches you a moral that you should learn to be truthful. If you do something wrong, same thing will happen to you. Because the baker was selling less quantity of bread, he was getting less quantity of butter from the farmer. So children, this is the story. You read the chapter thoroughly. Okay, once again you read it, go through it, and we'll discuss the written assignment, the hard words in the next class. Till then children, have a good day. Thank you.